raining outside. We're wet.
It's the first day of shooting. We're running a little behind.
Watch it! Watch out! Watch out!
That's why we have tomorrow and the next day and the next day and the next day to shoot.
Weather.com is now the most visited site on my computer.
Storytime was chosen because it was character-driven, it had a nice structure, it just sort of had a character, a central character around which it revolved, who was interesting and believable in the film.
The film Storytime is about a woman in transition.
It wasn't a terribly visual script at first. It really was a lot more like a teleplay than a film. And so I spent a lot of time thinking about what things looked like and trying to decide what sort of visual things to lock into. And because Renee is an alcoholic, I decided that water was something that we could use as a metaphor. I think doing the car gag for the students was a lot of fun.
Headlights are going to be in there all the way in the water, probably the front wheel well, and most of the front driver compartment. It's supposed to be all in the water and everything like that. From there, what we're going to do is we have tubing running back, and Ryan is going to sit in the back of the car. And he's going to wire two smoke machines that we have right there to get smoke coming out of the hood to sort of give like an engine failure sort of thing or whatever, give a nice little effect across the water.
The most dangerous stunt of the film shoot is done.
It was glorious.
It's out of here an hour earlier than we thought it was going to be. So everything's good about tonight. That's Bill, and he's our truck driver, and he took care of us. So,
surprisingly, working with the Grand Valley State students is not much different than working with a professional crew. There's less experience, but on the other hand, the professional crews have their own foibles. Students here are very serious about their work and want to learn and want to do their work, and it's great. I mean, you can see them sort of developing very quickly over a short period of time.
This is the glamorous part.
Summer film is a much more extensive project. You have a lot more equipment, using much more high-tech equipment, and equipment that I will probably never make that much money in my life.
Working with Jack Anderson and Bob Hirsch has been a pretty interesting and positive experience, I think. It's been great to pick both of their brains in a sense.
Jack is very knowledgeable about the entire industry. He knows something about every single position. It really makes you realize how skilled he is at being in a supervisor position and just how well he gets people to do what he wants them to do without making them feel like they're being ordered to do it.
I'm sitting there, I'm learning so much about why he's doing what he's doing, not just seeing what's happening, but I'm learning why he's doing it. And I'm able to interact with him a little bit and kind of give my own suggestions here and there.
Yeah. This was the first time that I had the pleasure to work with Bob Hirsch. He keeps the set light and he has a very artistic vision of what he's doing. As he's directing the actors, he goes in the same way. He tries to push the actors towards what he wants, not necessarily telling them exactly what he wants. He wants them to reach it themselves.
We're offered something that's comparable to a Hollywood-style production, and you don't see that at a lot of different film schools.
It's taught me a lot about how to cope with situations that just happen, which is always going to happen on a film.
The interesting thing about my job is that it has nothing to do with the story. Like, when I'm on set, half the time I don't even know what scene we're getting. I don't even know, like, the whole makeup of the scene. I don't even know what's going on. I don't know what the actors are doing, because my job is just technical.
I'm taking orders from the best boy, who's taking orders from the gaffer, who's taking orders from the director of photography. And a lot of times when I'm told to set something up, it should have been set up about 5-10 minutes ago. So there's a lot of that constant momentum on the set. It's prepped me quite a bit, you know, to know that this is not, there's no slacking. When something needs to be done, it needs to be done right away.
It takes a more serious level working on Storytime, and you get to know people in a different way.
Anyone that can be on a summer film, it's just an amazing experience. We've bonded in ways you can't explain it. We're a team, we're a family, we're friends, people that I didn't know coming in here, and now a week and a half later, you know, I'm going and hanging out with them off set, I'm with them all day on set, and it's just this family and this whole different world for these 2 weeks.